It's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. No wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down, coming after me. Oh, the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. Oh, it chases me down, fights till I'm found.
All right, good afternoon, good evening, good evening, good evening. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I have a little camel trouble. So, going back to the original. Good afternoon, good evening. Welcome to Prayer Life Ministries International Prophetic Studies. I am Dr. Apostle Dexter Hall. And to be home on behalf of my lovely wife, Dr. Prophetess Hope Hall, and the Prayer Life Ministries International family, we like to greet you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This is an exciting time tonight when we have the woman of God coming forth for Bible study. I just hope you got your seat belts and get ready because it's about to be fire. Amen. She don't like it when I say that word, but nevertheless, to God be the glory. I'm going to go into prayer, and then we will turn it over to the woman of God. Dear gracious Father, we thank you right now. We thank you for all that you're doing in our lives, Father, that you continue to keep us in perfect peace as we keep our minds stayed on you, Father. No matter what challenges, no matter what situation that we may encounter, Father, your strength, Father, and your grace, which is sufficient enough, continue to help us, push us, and provoke us, and that we can go forth and walk according to your word and walk according to your plans that you have for our life, Father. Father, we thank you for the love that you continue to show among us, Father, even when we have missteps, even when we have trips, Father, you are still there to help pick us up, Father. You help us to dust the dirt off our knees, Father, when we fall, and you pick us up and we continue to walk as you continue to hold our hand. Even in the valley of shadow of death, you are still with us, Father. Even when we're at the mountaintop of victorious, you are there with us, Father. So we thank you right now. We cannot praise you enough, Father. We cannot praise you enough for all that you are doing right now, because it's been just a great opportunity to be willing vessels, Father, yielded vessels for the work and the service that you have for us for this kingdom, God. We are thank you for allowing us to be chosen for this kingdom, God. And we know it's by your strength and by your indwelling Holy Spirit within us through Jesus dying on the cross and being buried and being resurrected on our behalf that we can connect with you, Father, because he is the truth, the way, and the life, Father. So we thank you right now that you have opened our eyes so we can see from your divine realm, Father, that we are able to see from above and not beneath, Father, that we are able to walk into the marvelous light that you have called us to, Father, that we become the light of the world. We come the salt of the earth, Father, that we're able to add flavor and through influence, Father, that we're able to speak to people and give them a more excellent and better opportunity to know that you love them regardless of the situations, Father. Father, we just pray right now for our evangelism to increase, Father, that we, because this is time and a season that our evangelism are increased for your purpose, for your kingdom, Father, because we're here on assignment for to gather your people, Father. You said that there the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few, Father. We are the few laborers that are standing by and going into the fields, Father, and it's time to collect your harvest, Father. And as we are fishermen, Father, we are fishing for the men and the women of God to come forth so they can change their relationship from being a servant into being a son, Father. Being a prince or a princess to the king of kings and lords of lords, Father. We thank you because we are from a royal priesthood. So we thank you for what you are doing in our lives, God. Strengthen us, Father. Clear our mind and our mindset that we just wholly walk in agreement, that we hear the things that you say, Father, and we follow the words and instructions you give to us no matter what, that we don't change our posture because of situation and challenges that we have in our life, that we do not bend to the left or bend to the right because of situations, God, that we stay in your presence. We stay in your faith. We stay on assignment, Father, because we one of the things that we know that we're walking on your in assignment with you, Father, you're with us, Father. You're walking us all the way through this trial, through this tribulation, Father. You said if we resist the devil, you will flee, the enemy will flee. So, Father, strengthen us now so we can resist the enemy so he will flee, Father. So we can stand and we can become boldly upon your throne. We can stand up boldly and worship you. We can stand boldly and speak your word like never before, Father. God, we just thank you because you're a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path, Father, that you are continuing to show us the way, Father, that each step we need to take. So we give you all the glory and praise and honor. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. At this time, Dr. Prophetess Hope Hall, it's on you, woman of God.
Well, can you hear me?
Yes.
Amen. To God be the glory. Good evening. Glory to God. We give him glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He is so awesome. He's my hiding place. He's my hiding place. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. We glorify you. You are my hiding place. You always fill my heart with songs of deliverance whenever I am afraid. I will trust in you. You are my hiding place. You always fill my heart with song of deliverance whenever I am afraid. I will trust in you. I will trust in you, Lord. Oh, if a weak say, yeah, I am strong in the sense and the strength of you, Lord. You are my hiding place. Oh, you always fill my heart with songs of deliverance whenever I am afraid. I will trust in you. I will trust in you, Lord. Hail, let we say, I am strong in the strength of He is, he is my hiding place. There's nowhere I'd rather be than in your will. Oh, Lord, you are my strength. Oh, God, with songs of deliverance, whenever I'm going through, Lord, when I'm ever going through, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. You are my hiding place. Yes, you are. You always fill my heart with songs of deliverance. With deliverance, Lord, when I sit with you, when I sit with you, God, when I spend time in your arms, God, I will trust in you. I will trust in you, God. I will trust in you, God. You're the only wise God. You're the only, 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 only wise God. I want to follow you wherever you go, God. Oh, we thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord, in you. You are my hiding place. Yes, you are, Lord. You always fill my heart with songs of deliverance whenever I am afraid. I will trust in you, Lord. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, right now, for you are glory. You are mighty, and I give you glory today, Father. I worship your holy and righteous name because you're a God, the I am. You are the everything. You're my Elohim. Father, as I get ready to produce this word, God, that you have so eloquently written for me, Father, and use my hand as a ready writer. Let me release, God, so that you can increase. Because you are my hiding place, God. You are the one that I love. You are my soul praise. You're my soul worship. You're everything that I am and everything that I need, God. And there is none like you, Father, in the world. So, Father, every ear, God, that's on here, let them hear, Father. Those who are watching in the replay, God, let them pick up something in their heart, God, that's going to cause them to change. Not that it's just a good word given by a good vessel, but a great word given through the vessel by the voice of God. So, Lord, I thank you and I glorify your holy and righteous name. It is your moment. It is your time. And I am ready to do exactly what you have said to do, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for every ear that hears. Let every eye be open. In the mighty name of Jesus, hallelujah, hallelujah, and amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Today is an awesome day in the Lord. It always is. I thank God for being God. I thank him for all that he's done, all that he's doing, all that he's about to do. Well, this word came to me a while back. It was before the storms that it came to me. Glory to God. And then there is a prophetic presentation that I am going to present to you in a little while. But right now we're going to go with this. To God be the glory. I pray that someone gets this and they actually apply this to their life and know that God is in control. My Lord, hallelujah. God is in control. So I thank the Lord for tonight, and bear with me as I go through this, because I am going to cover, I'm going to do a lot in the little bit of time I have, so I need you to follow me, because you will hear me just reading for the most part, and as Holy Spirit leads, I will minister that word. I want to welcome you all to the prophetic Bible study, to my first love, Jesus Christ, and then my second first love, Apostle Dr. Dexter Hall, in the name of Jesus, who I love so dearly. He pushes me to go forth, and that is a good thing. And I want to thank God for everyone who is listening and everyone in the sound of, at the sound of my voice. I want you to hear it closely. It was a word that I ministered. Well, I did minister this word actually in service, but it did come up and I was approached via whatever, after saying that, hey, you was talking to me. But that was just a small amount. God wants me to give you the bigger version of this word. And that wasn't the only person that came to me and was like, oh my God, you're speaking to me. Because what we want to do is teach how to obey God so that you can get what you need to get done. And sometimes obeying him, sometimes confirmations are not comfortable. They don't feel good. they're not captivating to you because it's a rough burden that you have to carry. And sometimes you got to carry it through a rough journey like Jesus did. He went through a rough journey in the short hours of his life. And then in that journey was a lot of pain, and obedience is where his suffering was, but it was a great thing for us. He cared about us. So now it's our turn to be obedient. And so, glory to God. Let me look at the, okay. So tonight I want to talk about confirmation. Lord, when I say that word, glory to God. When I just say that word, I feel some kind of way. I don't know. It's just a big word because I know that I have heard of many confirmations from my life. And if I had not followed what God was saying, there's no telling what, where I would be, or if I'm still fighting that same battle today, listening to God and trusting him. So confirmation is a strategic direction from God. And when you avoid it to take an easy route, you miss God. And your already challenged situation gets worse because of disobedience. So we get confirmations a lot of times when you're going somewhere. If you got a dentist appointment, glory to God. And you fill out the thing when they say confirm your appointment. So when you confirm your appointment, then that means you're committing to that appointment. And of course, in the natural, if you can't make it, it's best to call. It's the best to let somebody know. And that's in anything. Glory to God. That's in anything. When it comes to confirmation, I'm going to give you definition of confirmation and obedience. So remember, confirmation, and this is in the spirit realm, the supernatural realm, is a strategic direction from God. And when you avoid it to take an easy route, you miss God, and your already challenged situation gets worse because of disobedience. So we're going to read 1 Kings chapter 13, starting at verse 11 through 26. And again, and if you see my hair going up, I got the wind blowing because the Holy Spirit just burning me up right now. So I'm trying to stay cool. Praise the Lord. To God be the glory. And so you see what we do this 1,000 times, the wind may be blowing me out of here, but it's okay. All right, to God be the glory. And so we're going to 1 Kings 13 chapter 11 through the 26th verse. And in the New Life Translation, the New Living Translation. Can y'all tell I'm a bit nervous? So come with me, please. I don't know what Holy Spirit is going to do. So some of you may know about the man of God and the prophet, right? So the man of God, I'm just going to give you a preface because I don't have to read everything, but he went to this, he was in front of this king, and God was mad because he was acting out against the king Jeroboam, if that's how you say his name, forgive me. He was acting out against the king, altar of Bethel. And so when the king did that, his hand was paralyzed, And when his hair was paralyzed, he got upset and he was like, oh my God, I can't pull my hand back, because, you know, he reached out and said, get that man. He was trying to get this man of God. And when he reached out, his hand stopped right there. And he could not pull it back. Can you imagine not being able to pull your hand back? And immediately he said, he stepped in and said, please, man of God, can you pray to your God to release this paralysis on my hand? And the man of God said, yes, I will. So in that, the after he did that in the man's hand, it was a miracle, right? And God showed mercy to the king for acting out against the altar of Bethel. And so the king Jeroboam wanted to bless the man of God and say, hey, you can have anything you want to drink, anything you want to eat. I'm a blessing you. You can come. It's a gift. I thank you for doing that. And the man said, God, and the man told the king, like, even if you gave me half of everything you own, you know, I'm not doing this. He said, because the Lord gave him a command that he should not eat. And that was in verse 9, when the Lord gave him the command, the man of God, he gave him the command that he must not eat or drink anything while he is at the place. And he not to return to Judah the same way he came. So he had to go to another way. So he left Bethel. Okay, so keep Bethel, you know, in your mind. So now let's go to verse 11. Now, this is where, when I get ready to read this, we can look at it and as a two ways, as a revelation that God gave me in this, as a confirmation and obedience. So as we're in 1 Kings 13, just in case those of you who just joined, 1 Kings 13 chapter, verse 11, come on, Holy Spirit. As it happened, there was an old prophet living in Bethel, and his sons came home and told him what the man of God had done in Bethel that day. They also told their father what the man had said to the king. The old prophet asked them, which way did he go? They showed their father which road the man of God had taken. Quick, saddle the donkey, the old man said. So they saddled the donkey for him, and he mounted it. Verse 14. Then he rode after the man of God and found him sitting under a great tree. The old prophet asked him, are you the man of God that came from Judah? Yes, I am, he replied. Then he said to the man of God, come home with me and eat some food. No, I cannot, he replied. I am not allowed to eat or drink anything here in this place. For the Lord gave me this command, you must not eat or drink anything while you are there. And do not return to Judah the same way you came. So we know that the old prophet is from Bethel. So he went a different way, but he's still kind of in Bethel, but he's going a different direction still. Because you know how you can go different places in states and go use different roads, country roads instead of the highway, and still, you know, you're going out of the way of the traffic. Maybe, you know, when you like, you see that Siri showing you traffic and you may go out of the way, but you're still in the same county or the same city, in which, glory to God, which, gets you on the right road. So, and you still go back the way you came, but you're going different, right? So, but in verse 18, let's go to verse 18. But the old prophet answered, I am a prophet too, just as you are. And an angel gave me this command from the Lord. Bring him home with you so he can have something to eat and drink. But the old man was lying to him. So they went back together, and the man of God ate and drank at the prophet's home. Verse 20, then while they were sitting at the table, a command from the Lord came to the old prophet. He cried out to the man of God from Judah. This is what the Lord says. You have defied the word of the Lord and you have disobeyed the command the Lord your God gave you. You came back to this place and ate and drank where he told you not to eat or drink. Because of this, your body will not be buried in the grave of your ancestors. So he's already told him that he's dead. That's a wrap for him. Verse 23, after the man of God had finished eating and drinking, the old prophet saddled his own donkey for him, and the man of God started off again. But as he was traveling along, a lion came out and killed him. His body lay there on the road with the donkey and the lion standing beside it. People who passed by saw the body lying in the road and the lion standing beside it. And they went and reported it in Bethel, where the old prophet lived. Verse 26, finally, when the prophet heard the report, he said, it is the man of God who disobeyed the Lord's command. The Lord has fulfilled his word by causing the lion to attack and kill him. Now we can look at that too as a false voice. The prophet in this instance represents self. So this is the revelation, even though it's a false voice on the outside. So your outside side note is only trust, be careful of the false voices. Be careful of false human voices. As well as any other voices that you hear from other people that may be telling you or teaching you opposite of what you've learned from the Bible. Glory to God. And so in this instance, I want you all to go into your supernatural mind, and this prophet represents self. So self says, I heard from God too. And sometimes we don't recognize self if we're not in the depths of the Holy Spirit, if we're going through some things and we're not really in tune with holy presence, then when we're going through, it's going to last a whole lot longer than you really want it to be. You're going to go through some trouble that you don't have to go through. Sometimes, God says, my burden light, my yoke easy. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And we just want to take our own burdens and our own ideas and think the easy way out. So confirmation is verification, proof, testimony, endorsement, authorization, agreement to, consent to. So if we go with confirmation and you trust the man or woman of God speaking to you in your life, and you've never told a soul about something, or you didn't tell a person about something and God gave you a specific thing to do and you confirmed it. You confirmed it by verifying to them, hey, God did tell me that as well. Glory to God. He did tell me that. He told me to do this. And then not only that, you're speaking to a prophet that I've also learned to give you instructions. And then you get these instructions and you've even had five confirmations from different people who may just be prophetic people. And yet you give them proof. You say, hey, you're right. That's how it's supposed to go. You testify to it like there's no way you could have known this because I've never talked to you about it. And then you endorse the God in them. So therefore you trust that voice. Hallelujah. And authorization, you get authorization. They agree and consent to it. So they agree to what God is saying. And so therefore their next step is obedience. When God gives you confirmation through other people and you're staying in the worship, it's not about, oh, well, I can do it if I want to. I don't have to do it. And, you know, maybe God is saying something else and I missed it. No, if you've already confirmed it, then trust God. Learn to trust God. So obedience follows your confirmation. And so the confirmation God had given to the man of God on the road was to not go back to the place and eat thing. The old prophet was from Bethel. And so he's telling him that an angel came to him. But if you trust God, you don't listen to the voices of somebody else. You don't listen to your own self talking to yourself. You say, okay, God, wait a minute. You told me that this is what you confirmed. And so I want to, God, I just want to, you got to seek him out. And you got to look at the road that he's taking you. And sometimes you say, well, I don't think God will take me on that. Around the bend and back in the corner. And remember, we suffer for Christ. So we got to go through some real tough times when it comes to the Lord. Everything ain't always going to be suddenly easy, automatic. My husband got 20-something no's until he got his yes. Glory to God. There was a fight in the prayer room of heaven with our angel Michael and the Prince of Air. And that right there was very difficult. For something to go forth. So obedience is compliance with an order, request, or law, or submission to another's authority. So you're going to submit to the things of God. If the man of God had to submit it, he told me, well, I'm a prophet just like you. Well, everybody's a prophet. If you don't foundation with God, you stop calling yourself a prophet. If you're not foundational with Jesus and Holy Spirit first, then you stop giving yourself a title because you're going to go through some stuff. Now, we're having this burden now. Now we're coming into this burden place. You are in a locked place that looks like heavy warfare. The battle is against you. You're not going to make it. It's just really bad. You don't know what to do. You get confirmation from somebody who has no idea that God had already spoke to you what you need to do. And then it looks like whatever God said you need to do, it looks very difficult. It looks it looks like, oh no, that's not what, you know, let me see him again. Right? And then you'll be like Balaam. You're kicking your donkey. Your donkey got to speak to you because you're out of order. Now God told you this. He gave you instructions. And guess what? Whatever he told you to do, God can get you out of that before you even get started because of your obedience. You can go crank your car, your gas is filled, and you're headed to where God told you to go. And then he may say, man of God, woman of God, here I am. Thank you for your obedience. You don't have to do that. Let me tell you what to do next. Oh my God. That is the obedience of God when you operate in the confirmation that he gave you. Glory to God. So it's compliance with an order. God gave you an order. He strategically directed your steps. He ordered your steps in the Lord. So sometimes you got to follow the steps that don't feel comfortable in order for God to do what he needs to do for you and you to overcome whatever battle looks unwinnable. Glory to God. And it might be a word I'm making up, but it is already victorious because you step out on faith, believe what he told you in the many confirmations that you got, and you believe God and you stay in the worship. Glory to God. So your compliance, obedience is you follow the request of the Lord. You submit to his authority. See, if I give you a word from the Lord, you're not submitting to my authority. You're submitting to the voice of God in me's authority. Glory to God. And when you tell me confirmation, I'm going to hold you to that confirmation. Now watch this. I can't make you do it. God didn't force the man of God to go to Bethel to that man's house. He didn't force the man of God to listen to his voice, come tell him, hey, an angel spoke to me too. So you consider the angel an angel of God when the Bible says there's false angels of light in the earth? If you know God and he gave you the first voice, he gave it to you. Why in the world are you trying to walk to your death? Thank God we don't have to, we not dying for that, because the Jesus was not there in the flesh at that time for us to just get that second opportunity, for us as the man of God to get a second opportunity. So I'm getting ready to just read through this. I want you to really hear it closely because we have a time frame and I really want you to watch the prophetic video. Okay, so listen closely. When someone says, I see you doing this, that means that, let me go explain that part right quick. It's like, when I see you writing a book, and you're like, oh, yeah, because I've been struggling with a book. But the Lord said, if you go and talk to this person, and this person would direct your attention to the book. But I've been struggling with the book. But you know what? God did mention something to me about talking to that person. And this struggle has been such a battle. If you're struggling with your kid, and the Lord says, well, if you go and you worship me and you lay your face down before me, you turn your plate down 7 days and just drink water and worship me, your child, glory to God, you ain't got to worry about nothing because I already got it in control, right? Then that's what you do. But if you don't do that and you only go down three times, come on, Lord, I need to take my medication. And the Lord said, oh, already gave you the information, which means that you won't be sick on my watch. Glory to God. Hallelujah. So you gotta follow what God is saying. And confirmation. God gives you confirmation, your strategic place, the obedience. So I just wanted to give you that. Okay, when someone says, I see you doing this, whether it is a prophet or a prophetic person. And sometimes they'll give you some type of instruction. Most of the time, the prophet will give you instructions to follow. A true prophet, a real prophet of God. I'm just gonna get that out there. And sometimes they'll give you some type of instruction to help you along the way, according to the Spirit of the Lord, which is Holy Ghost. Sometimes it can be a future tense, but a lot of times it's a now confirmation of what God is saying and has already said to the person. When a person says to me that what I have said was a confirmation of what God tells them, generally obedience should follow. Unfortunately, people don't fall into that category and they end up worse than they started or no better than before. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Obedience is essential to a confirmation or just hearing the word of the Lord speak to you as you desire to get out of your situation into a better situation, a victorious situation. The number one thing, you must die to self. If the man of God died to his flesh, then the prophet that we call flesh, the prophet, that old prophet from Bethel, he would have not heard him. He would have said, you are lying, you, because he is so welled up in the Lord. He just produced a miracle. So that means that no matter how many gifts you have, if you don't follow the Lord, your gifts only help somebody, but they don't help you. A lot of people spend a lot of time praying to God to help them through a difficult time. And it looks like there is no answer, but there is only trouble. You always want God to hear your prayers and answer you. But when he gives you the answer and it looks like the most difficult or challenging instructions, somehow you find your way to the voice of another God in form of your flesh, Satan, are one of his imps as a false angelic being. The answer then looks absolutely easy. So then you say, God told me to do this. And then when it doesn't quite work out the way you think, you have moved off the path that Master Counselor Holy Spirit placed you on. You decide to change what he had already told you. Therefore, you are out of order and operating in disobedience. God is not wishy-washy because he's not double-minded and he never will be. Follow God's wisdom, or if he sends someone that is giving you with God's wisdom, follow it and see where it leads. God will never fail. Hallelujah. God will never fail. Until we operate in obedience in the authority of Jesus, we will endure more and more hardship, and victory will not locate your eyes. When you say that's what God told me to, but go into a different direction, calling it God, you lie on God. Even Jesus operated in obedience under his Father's authority. That would be John 12, verse 49 to 50. I don't know which, I didn't write it down which translation it was, but it says, I don't speak on my own authority. This is Jesus speaking. The Father who sent me has commanded me what to say and how to say it. And I know his commands lead to eternal life. So I say whatever the Father tells me to say. So even Jesus operated, thank you, the NLT. Even Jesus operated under the voice of his Father God. He didn't say more. He didn't listen to another voice. He listened to the things of God. If Jesus did not follow the things of God, he would have no longer been perfect and we would have been in trouble. So God tells you the truth. He gives you confirmation. You obey that confirmation. Let God lead you from there. You don't think about the burden that you're carrying. You just travel to where he's telling you to travel to. You move in your mind where he tells you to move. You operate where he tells you to operate. God is a man, and in Numbers 23 and 19, God is a man so he does not lie. He is not human, so he does not change his mind. Jesus, has he ever spoken and failed to act? Not for me, he hasn't. When God give me confirmation, even if I don't know how I'm going to get there, I'm sure going to scramble for his resources. I'm sure going to scramble for his wisdom. I'm not going to try to just take it on my own because somebody said, write a book. I'm going to go out there and write it. No, I'm going to say, Father, what is that? Show me how to do it. You gave me a book years ago and now it's coming back. Oh, I'm in this image. I'm in this image of mentorship. God told me that's what be my mentorship, but he didn't say go right then. I asked him about it. I said, God, I seek this for you. And now he gives me the right time to step out into the wind of his wings. Glory to God. So has he ever promised and not carried it through? Not for me. I am going to obey the confirmations. So not operating under his direction is disobedience. I've heard people be hyped, emotional, a feel-good moment, maybe even a spiritual place about the confirmation and the instructions that follows. But then they come back to me and say, God said to do something else. And when it happened, they failed and were highly upset and didn't understand why they fail. Sometimes people do get hyped about it. To God be the glory. So, man of God, if you can play that, share your screen, please. I want y'all to listen to very carefully. I want y'all to pay attention to this because this came to me a couple of days ago after this thing was written. It's going to be about 10, 10 minutes long, I think. Glory to God.
Can you hear it?
Yes. Now I can't. Because there should be something going on now. There it is. Turn it up a little bit.
Your child needs these three key factors to get
it's into. Okay. It's just a commercial. Just tap on.
Whatever is the matter, dear boy? And what in the world is that awful thing on your back? I'm actually on my way to... Where are my manners? Worldly's the name. Worldly first, Wiseman last, of course. Don't ever mix them up. You were saying?
That I am on my way to the Celestial City by way of the gate, where I hope to get rid of this burden which is getting bigger by the hour.
Ah, and you would do well to do that, dear boy. But,
Yes?
Well, who told you you could get rid of that over there?
A good man that came upon me in my hour of need.
Evangelist, of course. Oh, dear, dear, dear.
What is it?
And you've already come all this way.
Oh, well, dear, dear, dear. What?
It's just that this evangelist...
Yes?
Well, he's a little...
So, he's...
Yes, he is. Loony as a bird. The poor chap has his head in the clouds.
Oh, no!
So what on earth was this evangelist thinking, sending you in that direction, full of nothing but trouble and danger, which I can see by the scratches and the tears and the mud you've already experienced? So, don't go that direction, which is silly nonsense, but you go in this direction, which is not.
But,
no but, do not argue with me, you listen. So, you keep going that way. Good boy, you keep going that way and do not stop, no matter what things begin to look like. Just go in the direction I tell you until you get to a village called Morality. There you will find the hill. You will know you're at the hill because the signs will tell you. There, not at that silly gate you were telling me about, you will be told how to get rid of that ugly thing.
Too many?
Daddy, can there ever be enough? Come now. You want that burden off, don't you? Come to me. Do as I say. Come now. You're still too far away. I can hardly see you now. Keep up, man, keep up. I can't do the work for you. You missed a sign there. You missed what I say.
I can't.
You expect me to help you when you cannot even help yourself? On your feet.
Oh, what am I going to do?
How is it you turned out of the way so quickly?
I don't know.
Ha!
Oh dear. Come on, let's get you out from under all that. Commandments cannot give you what you seek, Christian. They will only be a reminder that you are not able to keep them all. Legality can never rid you of your burden.
Say what?
I said...
I'll show you what I can do. Prepare to see my power, you wretched man.
Christian, run!
Bury you under the weight of my power, I will. And rid the world of your burden. And you...
comes toppling down, we are catapulted to the way. The way that you left off following.
You can skip this video, but you can't skip the truth. Right now, in North Gaza, children are...
It wasn't really my fault.
Oh, I see.
A man I met, a Mr. Worldly White...
Huh? That scoundrel.
Well, he said there was an easier way to get rid of my burden, and I
was led out of this way.
I thought...
You thought the king was leading you down a wrong path.
Well, no, I...
You brought this misery upon yourself by rejecting the very instructions the king sent to you, Christian.
You're right. It is my fault. I had no business listening to worldly wise men. It's no one's fault but mine, and I'm sorry. I'm...
Forgiven.
What? I'm...
Forgiven. If tears are any indication of regret, yours are. The king has said every misstep will be forgiven. Now, stand up. Continue the journey, for you have no time to lose. But learn, Christian, that there are two things this deceiver caused you to do. The first is that he caused you to so easily go out of the way. And second, that he made the difficulty of your journey something you wanted to avoid. Now, off to the gate with you. And remember, good Christian, do not leave the path again.
Hallelujah. I hope you caught that. He wanted an easy way to get rid of his burden instead of just staying on the path that God gave him because the burden was so heavy. Now, the beginning of the movie, the burden is something else about getting to the cross so that he could tell more people about God. But this burden we're talking about is things that are going on in your life. So question, what did God originally tell you? That's what you do. Of course, it would look a little far-fetched and out of the way. And of course, it would look way more difficult than you anticipated. But in the midst of the confirmation, there were multiple confirmations. And at the moment, it felt like God was doing something awesome.
but you became out of focus. And it only takes one misstep to get you out of alignment. And that is caused by distractions, interference, flesh. It was easier than what God had already told you to do. Ultimately, it's going against God, what God has commanded, and disobeying how he wants you to live, Disobedience is rebellion against God, simply not trusting that he knows best on your behalf. Unfortunately, in Kings, the man of God was not obedient or discerning. So death was his end, but delay can be yours. If God gives you information and trusted voices confirms God without knowing anything, then I strongly suggest you go with God, because he's already has the plan. Beware of the hindering spirit, the blindsiders. That was why worldly wise men. And remember, he said, don't mix them up. Don't ever say wisely first and then worldly. He said, say worldly wise men. Glory to God. And so beware of hindering spirits, the blindsiders, the one that keeps you blocked from your breakthrough. It will connect with delay, the spirit of delay, and you will move out of alignment. The best way to do it is to just die to self through worship and forgetting about trying to fix your issue and depend on God for your already won victory. Glory to God. So I pray that this word, glory to God, has blessed you tonight. Confirmation is so key, and obedience is key. Sometimes it can look rough. Sometimes it can not feel like that. But if you trust God and you're dying to yourself daily, then you'll operate from God's confirmation into obedience and watch your victory go way beyond your imagination. Because God said he'll give you more than you can ask or than you can think in the name of Jesus. I pray tonight that there are those of you who have may have walked out of the will of the Lord, that you repent right now and never turn back that way again. When the man of God with the burden in Pilgrim's Progress, when he lied, and that song said, do not lie. That was the best legal advice he got, was do not lie. And so, but the evangelist let him know that he's already forgiven and to go the way that God sent him, to never return, to get off the path again. God bless you. I love you. I pray this has blessed you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah and amen.
Amen, amen. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Thank you, woman of God, for this great message, this exciting message, this message that even I wanted to make sure I get it all I could get in to make sure I challenge myself and make sure I'm following the word or confirmation that God has given me concerning my life and concerning the vision that we have as Prayer Life Ministries. And me being a father, me being a friend, me being a leader, spiritual leader, and me just being a brother, you know, I just wanted to make sure. So thank you for this word, just to remind us that, you know, confirmation. I'm going to go into mine before I let someone else, because I took some notes, but I'm going to be brief. Like you start off, confirmation, strategic direction from God. That's powerful within itself. One of the things I want to point out, even with that, looking at the Pilgrim Progress, it's a great movie. I get excited every time I look at different parts of it. Definitely, it's one of the things whenever, you know, I ain't going to say whenever. So when the time is manifest, when we have youth, you know, adults too, but especially youth, that's going to be one of the curriculums that we put out, that they watch Pilgrim Progress, because it's a great opportunity from an animation set point. How this walk works. If you ever get a chance, look at Pilgrim Progress. It will bless your mind, your heart, and soul, because it shows you some things and you'll be like, wow. So enough of that. Let me talk about worldly wise men. When I saw worldly wise men, I thought of Psalms 1:1, when it says, and I'm gonna read the Passion Translation, because worldly wise men represented the wicked. Because they said, what delights come to the one who follows God's way? He won't walk in step with the wicked, because worldly wise men set him on a different path, or nor share the sinner's way, or nor be found sitting in the scorner's seat. See, and that's what the wicked do, to pull you off the path, pull you off track of what God is telling you. Just like you go and you correlate with the scriptures in 1 Kings 13:11-26 about the prophet and the old prophet. The old prophet took the man of God off his journey and his path. He was in his right mind, and this is some bullet points I want you to take here. Concerning 1 Kings 13:11-26, we must follow the instructions of the Lord entirely. Do not take shortcuts. Follow instructions entirely. We get in trouble when we take in shortcuts, or we go out of step or out of turn, because we mess up the flow where God has for us, right? And then another thing, my wife kind of mentioned it, she was talking about discernment. I said, our discernment is necessary because someone that is on the same path as us can mislead us or misguide us. Because the situation is, as they see you going on your path, you being fruitful, they see you walking in God, and they see you yielding, they see you surrendering, they see God blessing your life, they get a little jealous and they get a little envy. So because they've been on the path a little longer, we give respect to people that we feel that may have been in ministry a little bit longer, but you always still got to discern, because they could be coming at you, their motivation or their motive could be of jealousy and envy, and they can misguide you. So that's why your discernment with the Lord has to be key. If he have told you something, you have to follow what the Lord say. Another thing, we have to make sure the individual is giving you the word from the Lord is serving the same Lord as you. Because if you really look at the scripture, it says, he said, your Lord, your God, or your Lord. The old prophet, he said, your Lord, your God. So that telling me there's a different relationship when he was talking about Lord. It was different, because he said, your God, your Lord. He didn't say it was his, but he was an old prophet. So that's why we got to be careful. Be careful of the false voices that you're listening to. That's a representation of the false vessel. That's why we got to have discernment, because when people are giving you advice or giving instructions and it come as a confirmation, follow what the voice of the Lord is telling you. That's just God is reminding you, I said this to you. Now I'm going to bring someone that you haven't even talked to bring you to what you have been thinking in your mind. So this is, I'm just letting you know. You should be in agreement, so now walk in it. That's what confirmation is. He's telling you, look, you already thought about it. I already told you, you need to believe and trust me, because you are having a relationship, because you're talking to me. I gave you insight. I gave you instructions. Now, someone else come and say almost identical or very similar to what God has instructed you, follow that word. And the old prophet did represent itself, because he said, I, like she mentioned, I am a prophet too. That's not how we do things. We allow the Lord to reveal who we are. I am this. Because for our example, let's look for example. When I was getting pushed forward as a, you know, to fall and walk into apostleship, I didn't go around and start telling, I wasn't the first one that said it, that I was apostle. I was actually one of the last one to say it, because even when I heard it, I struggled with it, because I wanted to make sure it was God. So I didn't rush into it because of what someone said, even though they was a trusted voice. I had to make sure that it was God for myself and make sure I walk in it and be able to be ready for it. Because sometimes you can hear it and you take off it, but you're not equipped and prepared for it yet. You know, because it's supposed to happen in the future tense, but we're ready to take off now. Now we're not equipped and not ready, and then we put ourselves in a bad situation. Confirmation is a verification of what you have received from the Father. Obedience should follow your confirmation of God's word. I love that, because when you get God's word, just as she mentioned about Jesus, what it says, I forgot what scripture. Oh, John 12, 49, actually 50, John 12 and 50, he don't just do anything unless his Father tell him. We have to be the same, because we are sons and daughters of the King. So we can't do anything. We should not move, we should not act or follow unless the Father tells us. This does not mean that you won't encounter challenges, but he is sure of victory if you faint not. That's Galatians 6 and 9 when it said, and let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we will reap if we faint not. Obedience is when you submit or yield to the instructions. When you're obedient, that means you submit it and you yield into what God has given you for your life. Sometimes you got to understand, you have to be obedient and follow the steps that God has given you, even though it's not what you want to do. Because you already, a lot of times we plan paths for us, we want to do it this way, and God said, no, I need you to go this way. If you just go this way, it's going to work out. But no, Lord, it looks better this way. This is when worldly wise men throw that gold, because it looked beautiful, it looked easy, so that's the path we wanted to take, because it was shiny. You know, we got to be careful of the false angel of light, because it shows shiny, but doesn't mean that's the right path, because it looks easy, it looked less restrictive, less challenging. We got to be careful about that. And like she was talking about, as a person that is in the office of a prophet, we have to understand this. When we are given prophetic word, the instructions should point the people back to Jesus. It has to point you back to him. That's authentic. That's what is going on. We must be patient in the process. God is God's time. We got to work. It's God's time and not ours. We have to be patient in the process. And finally, as one of my favorite things, you got to die to self during this process. Die to self. It will help you with your better with your discernment. It help you better with your hearing. It help better with your vision, spiritual vision, when you're seeking God from above and not beneath. So that's all I have. I hope these nuggets help you, as well as the word that came forth. At this time, I'm going to do it a little different since I got the control of the mic. all right. If you want to speak and you can raise your hand. All right, Minister Jason, go forth.
All right, can you hear me?
Yes, sir. We can hear you.
Yeah, I just got in, but I see what you were doing about that video, and yes, you have a point. You can really just take an easy way out when God puts you on a path. Because every place, every shortcut has a price for it. And this isn't something you can just rocket science in. I've learned that the hard way when trying to cut corners that doesn't work out for you. You know, something doesn't work out for you, you try this with Jehovah also. Because yes, Jehovah is patient, but in the long term, he is not what we call a respecter of persons. He's not just gonna, let that hold you or something, or let that go what you've done, because you could have done it his way, you chose to do it your way. That's mostly what I got to say.
Amen. Amen. Appreciate that. Appreciate you adding it too. And I want to add a little bit more. I think, and this is what I wanted to actually, I think, start off with, but thank you for reminding me so I can bring it back. I think a lot of times when we think of the Father, we think of God, we think of Him as a, has Him in war, destruction, killing people. But He is the God of love. He sent His, a part of Him to come down, Jesus, to be wrapped in flesh to save us. To we were bought with a price. He's a loving God. He loved us so unconditional that He said, because I shed my son's blood on the cross, I'm going to give you an opportunity to get it right. I just need you to trust me in this. Many times He covered the sin. He already paid the tab for our sin. He already paid the tab. You didn't even have to pay the tab. Only thing He asking is to follow what He is saying. So He's a God of love. We don't need to think of God always as destruction, and you know, and that, but that's based on your relationship too. I'm learning to fall in love with Him because I know who He is in my life. We have more of a relationship, and then it's just service. Because when you have a relationship, when it comes to service, it's not obligation. It's what you want to do because you love Him so much that you just want to do it, and you know it's needed because of your relationship. All right, who's next? You can raise your hand. All right, Evangelist Tina Thomas.
Good evening, everyone. I like what I heard tonight. This was good to be. We had to die to self, and what I heard was to stay on the path and to listen to God, because we can get our voices mixed up. We think that it's God, and we have to know God's voice when we hear God. God isn't a God that shouts at us. It's a small, still voice. And if God tells us something, God says what He says, and He means what it says. And His word is always going to line up with what the word says in the Bible. It's not going to line up with what man says. His word never changes. His word is what He told us to do. He said it and He meant it. So we can't never let nobody come and trick us and say, well, He meant that 10,000 years ago. He don't mean that for right now. So we got to know that the devil come to kill, steal, and destroy, and also confuse us. He know he come to mess with your mind. He plays in the battlefield of our minds. In this I heard that for us to stay on the path. And I ain't never said I want to be a preacher. I never couldn't speak in front of people, and I still get mixed up a lot. But I would sit here and try to write something, then I'd stop. But I always thought of a message, and it was stay on the yellow brick road of life. If we stay on the yellow brick road of life, we wouldn't mess up. But on the road of life, we're going to come on stuff, come across things that distract us, that's going to try to take us off of God's plan for our life, you know? And if you think about the movie, The Wizard of Oz, how, you know, they had the tree throwing apples, try to get you off the path. And every time she come off the path or the yellow brick road, that's when she got in trouble. And we got to kind of look at that like our life, because if we come off of that path of life that God has for us, that's when we get into trouble. And when God said in Matthew 7 that broad is the way with narrow, you know, I'm all confused right now, but you know, broad is the way, but narrow is the road. You know, it leads to destruction if we come off of the path that God has for us. Also, I have to keep dying to myself too, because I suffer from the spirit of offense. certain things happen. I said I wasn't going to mention, but I'm going to mention anyways, because I got to tell on my own self. Because if I don't tell on myself, I'll do it again and again. And I don't want to do that. I don't want to keep tripping over my own feet. Last time I was here, I think it was last Wednesday, and I had spoke in something happened. You guys, I don't know, inside joke or whatever, texting each other. And it made me feel like something I said, I'm like, you know, the devil's like, oh, see, you didn't know what you was talking about. They laughing about you. Oh, what you said wasn't this and that. And I had to, and I got off. And I shouldn't have let that happen. You know, because the devil, he comes in your mind and he plays with you. He gets in your mind and I'm like, well, I ain't going back there. I'm not going back there. But I had to come back and tell the devil, you are a liar. I'm not going to let you play in my mind like that. You know, I have to every day renew my mind. I have to die to self because that's part of that spirit of offense, you know? And it probably was nothing like that. But even if somebody do something you say, they find a chuckle about it. They don't like it or whatever. It's not about that. It's all to bring the glory to God, you know? And basically, that's all I had to say. Thank you for letting me share. Bye.
Amen. Amen. Well, one of the things I just want to encourage you, you know, until you get, you know, to that fear breaks off you, continue to write. And you got to understand this, just continue on, you know. Don't get discouraged if you mix up the scripture or things like that. That comes more when you stay engaged in and you continue to read it. You will get it. Look, I'm a testimony myself. I had a bad speech impediment. So I was very terrified speaking in people, speaking in front of people. But it was the Lord that helped guide me where I'm speaking to you now. Normally, I couldn't stand social media or anything. But because the Lord is helping me, the spirit within me is helping me to be bold and it's helping me to process, it's going to work out. So don't get discouraged. If you mess up on some words, the Lord knows what you're saying. And you just learned, you know, if you write it down, read off what you say and then correct it. That's all. Don't get discouraged. We all have to come from some way, some different than others, but we all going on this path. Amen, Evangelist Tina.
Amen.
All right. Evangelist Talia, let's go.
Good evening, everybody. And to Miss Evangelist Tina Thomas, I stumble all the time. And I'm still stumbling and God working on me. I'm a work in progress. But I know what I mean, and he know what I mean. So it is what it is. We do it on purpose, Miss Tina. Unapologetically on purpose. We mean that. So what I got out of it is, oh, man, let me see if I can say this. See, Miss Evangelist Tina, I said it right that time. Deuteronomy. Your message took me to Deuteronomy, and it's and it was a message that God had gave me a while back. It was about the Israelites being at this mountain for too long, and they had just been camped for too long. And it just reminded me of them being on that path that God had for them. And it reminded me of my own situation. You know, through that situation, God was guiding them through it. He opened the Red Sea. They were able to go walk on the sand through the water and everything. And then they still got off the path. They started making idols and all kind of stuff, you know. So there are times where we can get on a path and it's good. That's what it is. It's good. He given us water. He given us bread. It's already told us. Like when they were camped at that mountain, he gave them specific instructions. I need you to do this. I need you to do that. I need you to do this. And I need you to do that. And I need you to do this. He didn't say that when you did this, it was going to be real super easy. He didn't say when you do that, it's going to be super easy. He didn't say that you weren't going to meet challenges because the Bible says it's not easy. But he did say, but your black you kids. So you question me about what I've told you that I've already given you. I've confirmed everything that You've seen all the confirmation. So why are you questioning me when it gets a little difficult? So it's like God is saying, this is what I'm getting. It's like, I'm just telling you, I'm being open and y'all knowing my business now though. But it is, I have been questioning God. I'm like, God, this is too hard. Like it, I don't know. This is what you.
Is she breaking up for you or just me?
And you know, this is how, you know, maybe you wanted me to do that temporarily, but he was like, my word is my word. Am I okay?
You're good now. Go ahead and continue. It's great. Good story.
Okay, I'm sorry. So he's saying, my word is my word. Trust me, my word is my word. Through the ups, when it's good, you trust in me and you all good and it's all gravy. In the bad times or the tough times, you still got to trust me because this is what it takes for me, for you to get to where I need you to go. So that's what God gave me. He says,
amen, amen, amen. Yes. Huh, that's good. He's basically like, just trust me. And that's a lot of things that, you know, God have us dealing is like, just trust me. I'm walking with you. I'm here with you. I know you're in this valley moment, but just trust me. Trust me and believe that I can get you through this. But I need you. Just trust me. Amen. All right, Pastor Jay, let's go. Let's go.
Blessings. Blessings to everyone. Giving honor to God. Dr. Apostle and Dr. Prophets. This message was awesome. I can tell you, when you started playing the video, I had a whole Kool-Aid smile because I love Pilgrim's Progress. Every time I watch it, it's like new revelation just drops. I was introduced to it a few years ago when I first met Prophetess. She remembers. I remember the first time I watched it, I had tears just flowing because it was just so powerful. And that this confirmation is just so important for us to. When God gives us confirmations through his vessels, I'm going to say his vessel, his true vessels that speak his word, we have to, like Prophet say, follow it up with an action that's called obedience. You know, because I can remember many times where I've got confirmation for things and I didn't follow it up with obedience. And then and it led to destruction. It led me off of God's path, and basically I did my own thing, you know. But one thing that God has said to me while I was sitting here, and he was like, in those moments when you're in confirmation and you're following my ways and you move into obedience, in those difficult moments when you get to a place where you don't understand what I'm doing, you can also, you're seeking me, but I also put people in place for you to seek godly counsel so you can stay on my path so they can help you with those instructions that are given. Because I know there have been moments in my own life where I'm following what God is telling me, but the path becomes very hard. And some things I just didn't understand. So what did I do? I go out and I seek godly counsel from my leaders or whoever that the Father placed in my path for me to speak to. Most of the time it's my leaders, because I'm that type of person. I'm not gonna let everybody be in my ear, you know. But one of the, and another thing, and Evangelist Tina had hit on this, and Matthew 7, about the narrow way and the broad way. And it took me to I went further into Pilgrim's Progress when he had just finished, if you know the movie, you know, when he had just finished speaking with Holy Spirit and he got to the two paths. And he looked at the past. I think it was Passion and Patience. What's the name of the past? And Patience was the narrow. Passion was the broad. So he decided to take the way of patience, the narrow way, and the most, this, now I cry at this part every time, because you just, because in that moment you decide, okay, I'm not going the way that the world would decide on, with the worldly wiseness way. I'm going to stay on the path where I know that I can get to the king. I can get to God. He chose that way. And the burden, when you choose God, those burdens that you carry, they are easily just lifted off of you, because he says in his word, you know, take up his yoke. You release your burdens unto him. Cast all your cares unto him, to everything that you deal with, because he cares for you. He loves you. And that's all in moving in obedience when he give you the confirmation. Because a lot of times when we get those confirmations and we don't follow them, we're putting things on ourselves, and then we become weighty. And he says, I'll never put no more on you than you can bear. But then you get into your flesh, and then everything's become so weighty to you. Yeah, that's what we call, you pick up unnecessary stuff that's just was not even meant for you. So the confirmation was amazing. And I remember when Apostle taught the lesson and the confirmations came behind it, and then Prophetess came behind him and talked about when you receive confirmation, just don't say, this is confirmation. Don't act on the confirmation. And I had an assignment that same day, and I did that assignment that same day. The Lord said, do it. He gave me confirmation that Sunday, and I was like, okay, let's do this. And there are many other things that I've done that confirm the whole move to Florida was a faith move, but it was, God had given me confirmation through the prophet, Dr. Prophetess Hope Paul. she had gave confirmation of when God was speaking to me concerning this move. And when I was unsure, I went back and asked questions. To go back to seeking that godly counsel, I asked questions, and she always helped me in those areas. Even Apostle, he helped me in those areas. So it was just, this is just amazing. It just teaches me to continue to just, you know, move in those confirmations, move in obedience to God. Because when we don't move in obedience, is you just put more on yourself, that you just put things on yourself that you shouldn't even have to deal with, because trusting God is where it's at, period. So that is all I have.
Amen. That was good. That was good. Definitely. Awesome. Yeah, definitely. That was definitely a faith move, that when you move from Georgia to Florida, you know, and you definitely had to make sure you heard the Lord. And I remember conversations having that, you know, and it worked out. He was not jobless. So to God be the glory. He worked it out. And when it was time to get you your spot, he worked it out. So that, you know, and even in the process, because sometimes it got a little tight, but nevertheless, you didn't faint not. So that's just another sign that once you get a confirmation from the Lord, even though it may not look like what you want to do, you need to do what he is telling you to do. So to God be the glory. All right, Minister Liz, let's go.
Greetings to the Heavenly Father. Greetings to the Dr. Apostle Dexter Hall. Greetings to Dr. Lady Prophetess Hope Hall. And greetings to everyone that spread to places. My God, Prophetess, this is a powerful word. Dying to self, that's good for me, because dying daily will help me get closer to the Father.
the Father. I'm sorry about that noise, y'all. It's thundering over here. So dying to myself daily will help me get closer to the Father. Not following every voice that I hear and stay in the path that God has already set for me or has placed me on. That's what I have. And if I follow the path that the Father gives me, everything will work out for me. Like Pastor Jay was saying that, you know, trials and tribulations only come to make us stronger. But if we follow the path and stay on the path of the Father, things will work out great. And then obedience is better than a sacrifice. And then I have Proverbs 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then I also have 1 Peter 5 and 7. When Pastor Jay was speaking, that's what I was hearing, 1 Peter 5 and 7. And about this worldly wise, I want to refrain from that. I just don't want to be who God calls me to be and focus on where the Lord is. I want to just focus on the prize, which is the high calling of the Father. I always want my discernment to be on point where I can see the enemy coming so I can be able to know how to defeat him. And then I want to seek godly counsel from my leaders and not from other leaders so that I don't have to get caught up in the wrong things and allow the enemy to deceive me or get me out of place where I don't need to be. So this word was so good for me, and thank you for allowing me to share a great word, Prophetess.
Amen, amen. Yeah, one of the things I want to even add to is the worldly wise men. You know, there's many people in our life could represent worldly wise men, where they can come into our life and give us worldly advice and make it look like it's coming from the kingdom. So we have to be mindful and careful about that. And that's why our discernment, because your discernment is as strong as your relationship with the Father. If you don't have a strong relationship with the Father, your discernment is going to be almost non-existent, because you're not going to have no power. You're not going to be able to see clearly. And then people that represent worldly wise men in your life going to be able to say some things and turn you away, even though the path they present to you look like it's the right way, but it's not the right way. So that's why we have to be careful. I mean, even family members could represent worldly wise men. I know a lot of times we want to exempt family members. A lot of times family members is one of the biggest obstacles, like I was talking this Sunday. Family members could be a big stumbling block. Even when I gave the example about my mom, even though she wasn't that, but given that example, I try to paint the picture that even our family, people that we love, could be a stumbling block, can pull us off the path that God has for us. And that's why we got to have our relationship strong and in the right mindset. So thank you for sharing. All right, do we have anyone else? If you don't know how to raise your hand, if you want to say something, just open your mic. I already know Minister Terrence, he's not able to say anything. So, you know, I got Johanna, Kawana, Gracie, Pat, that's Jacqueline, mom. So welcome, thank you. And Taisha, I haven't heard from you before. So open your mic and let's go.
Praise the Lord, everybody. It's just so ironic about how she was talking about her move to Florida, because I've been struggling with leaving Louisiana, and my desire is to come to Florida. So that was a confirmation for me. My thing is that God spoke to me, I guess he's talking to everyone in the same vein, because he told me to be careful of who I let into my ears, to have discernment to hear his voices and the people he has designed for to speak into my life in this season. And he told me to guard my mouth, to speak the things that he desires for me to speak. So guarding my ear gate and watching what comes out of my mouth, and watch the places and the people that are in my circle, because he has breaking me away from certain people. I know he has a great plan for me, but sometimes we desire to take other people that are expired in our lives, and God will not allow some blessings, allow some things to come forth until he cuts away, you know, like the plants, you have to prune it. And, you know, this is a purging, pruning season, because God desires for us to flourish and come out of stagnation. So that's what I wanted to say. You know, I just have to be obedient to his voice, not worry about what I see with my eyes, but stay focused, because the distractions are coming. And also, I'm one that when God tells me something, I would share with people. So he was like, your next move has to be in silence, because people will pray against your progress. And certain people that we trust, he revealed to me, are praying against us to sabotage us, because they don't want to see us ascend or elevate. So I thank God for that in this season. And I thank God for you, Apostle and Prophet, and the church family. Because, and I'm talking a little funny, because I had some tooth pulled, and I've been struggling with that. But I said, God, I am going to speak tonight, regardless how I sound, but just to hear his voice and to die daily, because whatever we feed is what's going to rain. If you feed the flesh, your natural man. So I'm in this season wanting to walk after the Spirit of God and let his Spirit reign dominant. So I have to get more into, you know, reading his word, things like that, and just try to perfect the things that, you know, concerns me, and God's going to partner with me to make those happen. So I love everybody, and y'all be blessed.
Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Yes. Keep that fire. Keep that pushing. You know, you have to have faith that you're hearing from the Lord. And that's the main thing. Make sure you're hearing from the Lord. And when he is telling you and giving you instructions, have faith that he's telling you something for a reason. And like the word came for, follow through, obey, be obedient. Amen. Amen. I see Minister Taisha, she got the grand son, so it was very powerful. She'll listen to the replay. Is the woman of God, Johanna, gonna purr, or is she gonna roar tonight? What's she gonna do? To God be the glory. I'm gonna push her. I'm gonna push her till I hear that roar, just like Simba. We're gonna push it till she roar. Amen, amen. All right, woman of God, Jacqueline, mother, Sister Gracie, you have anything to add? And if you don't, it's okay. We thank you for participating. We thank you for showing love to us, of being here on tonight. At this time, I will move. Oh, there we go.
Praise the Lord, everybody. I'm just sitting back, taking everything in, enjoying everything that I'm listening to. And I enjoyed the word tonight. And I just thank God for me to be on tonight. My voice go in and out, but either way, I still thank God.
Amen. We're definitely going to turn it over back to Dr. Prophetess Hope Paul as she give prayer, you know, for your voice. And Sister Kawana, she just had a wisdom going to the dentist. So before I give her opportunity, I'm gonna go over the announcements, and then I'm gonna turn it over to her. All right, you know, we have first, this is what I'm about to do. Everyone, If you can look into your what we call that chat, you see that link right there? If you are not following YouTube, us on YouTube, click that and just subscribe. We're trying to get our numbers up. You can do it right now. I can give you 30 seconds to a minute to click on that, to subscribe. We need these numbers. And share with your friends, the loved ones, you know, try to get them, because we have to get to a certain number so we can come forth strictly from YouTube live. That's what we're doing. And it will help so we won't have to totally depend on the Wi-Fi at the church right now until it get fixed. It's a company problem, tower problem. Don't know when the repair is going to happen. But if we get the numbers, we can come straight from the iPad, ministry iPad, and we'll be able to go forth, and we won't have no restrictions. Amen. So, all right, just as I'm talking, going into our service, we'll have service at Howard Johnson at Wyndham, Werner Haven, Florida. It is 1300 3rd Street Southwest, Werner Haven, Florida, 33880. We start service at 10:30 in the morning with intercession. We would love you for you to join us. If not, you can join us in person, which is the preferred method. But if not, you can catch us on social media. Right now, we're having a little small technical difficulties. But nevertheless, you can catch us on YouTube after, because we normally record and put it on YouTube. But hopefully, once we get this number, we can come straight from YouTube until the internet come back, because we normally use the streaming software that it comes on Facebook and YouTube, okay? So then you got the prophetic studies that we call it. It's on Wednesday at 7:30. Thank you for participating. And if not, you're not, we prefer you to be here to engage and participate. But happily, if you can't because you got a busy schedule or something coming up, you can go to YouTube. And when you're looking at the video, comment. It's open up where you can, if it hits something, put the comment in there. Give us feedback so we'll know if that message, it hit something. You know, sometimes there's a message that come from us, all our leaders, that is impactful. We want to hear from that. All right. Upcoming events. Oh, man. Upcoming events. How are we gonna do this? Upcoming events. Yeah, I know we have something coming out. Oh, that's not the right one. Uh-oh, hold on 1 second. 1 second. All right. November the 3rd. It's on. If you could be in the house, be there. Here's the flyer. We just got it. It is Prayer Life Ministry present the second annual all-white service, The Secret Place, Launching into the Deep. You thank Sister Kawana for giving us that theme, Launching into the Deep, through one of her engagement. Ephesians, the 3rd chapter, 14 to the 21st verse. The Passion Translation, November the 3rd, 10:30 a.m., 1300 3rd Street, Southwest, Winter Haven, Florida, 33880. All are welcome. Come lay it all on the altar and expect the supernatural as we launch into the deep of His refreshing atmosphere of love. And we'll be posting that shortly on different social media events. So we thank you guys. What else we have? Oh, October, the weekend of October 27th, we will not be in service. We'll be in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. So we're gonna have a high time in the Lord. We're expecting greatness. We're expecting supernatural. We're expecting empowerment. We're expecting us to be filled so we can come back and pour into you guys even more. You know, sometimes we have to be poured into so you can pour back into you, right? It's like a refreshing for us. So we will not have service on that Sunday. And we're doing something different this time. We're driving. My Lord, pray for us as we on that road, sometimes early Friday morning and coming back sometime early Monday morning. So praise, glory to God. Be with us. Amen. That is all the announcements that I have. Oh, yeah, well, I have to talk to the leadership team after. Might just have to switch the date on our upcoming event that we haven't mentioned yet. Might have to push it back a week. All right. At this time, I give the doctor, prophetess Hope Hall, great word, woman of God. It was awesome. You definitely touched some things, even in me. I appreciate you laboring for the Lord, bringing that word. It's on you now.
Amen. To God be the glory. Ooh, I just felt him all through that whole message. You know. And it was like, it's almost like God was saying, Ezekiel, eat the scroll. Don't be afraid of their faces. So, you know, if they're, because it's possible, you know, possibility people can get offended by it and say, oh, you tell, you know, whatever. Because I've been told that before and I'm telling their business because it was all in they, on their toes. I'm like, but when somebody else does it, you don't have no problem with them. So why you got a problem with me? To God be the glory. Well, it is what it is. And God gave me permission. I got permission. I got confirmation from him. So I was obedient. And so I pray that it frees somebody. The Ephesians 3 scripture is very powerful. I'm just going to read that really quickly. And then I'm going to move on forward since he's done the announcement. And then I'm going to close us out. Ephesians 3 verse 14 to 21 in the TPT. So I kneel humbly in awe before the Father of our Lord Jesus, the Messiah, the perfect Father of every father and child in heaven and on earth. Verse 16. And I pray that he would unveil within you the unlimited riches of his glory. Ooh, I felt that. And favor until supernatural strength floods your innermost being with his divine might and explosive power. Man, this is good. Verse 17. Then by constantly using your faith, the life of Christ will be released deep inside you, and the resting place of his love will become the very source and root of your life. 18 and 19. Then you will be empowered to discover that every Holy One experiences the great magnitude of the astonishing love of Christ in all its dimensions. How deeply intimate and far-reaching is his love. How enduring and inclusive it is. Endless love beyond measurement that transcends our understanding. This extravagant love pours into you until you're filled overflowing with the fullness of God. Never doubt God's mighty power to work in you and accomplish all this. He will achieve infinitely more than your greatest request, your most unbelievable dream, and exceed your wildest imaginations. He will outdo them all, for his miraculous power constantly energizes you. And 21, now we offer up to God all the glorious praise that rises from every church in every generation through Jesus Christ, and all that will yet be manifest through time and eternity. Amen. Launched into his deep is accepting everything in his love. Never doubt his mighty power in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. So we are launching into the deep on November the 3rd. And please invite your friends. Please invite people you know that need to come to the altar. Glory to God. We give God glory. And as he said, thank you for subscribing. hit the notification bell, and please invite your friends to subscribe too. You never know. Even if they're doing it just to help us, they're still doing it to help themselves if they actually watch the information that is put upon the screen. And so God is getting ready to achieve infinitely more than your greatest request. That is God. I think he wanted me to read that to remind you all that he is in control and that he is, whatever you're requesting, God is getting ready to give you more than enough. The overflowing abundance of his glory. And so that's why it's important that we obey the word of the Lord and in confirmation that he may give us. Sometimes he'll just give you his voice like he did the man of God on the street. He just gave him his voice and he knew his voice, but he listened to the voice of another man and not the voice of God. If God already told you don't, then don't. He told you to do, then do. In the name of Jesus. Well, God bless you. And I thank God for you tonight. Thank you for every word that was spoken. And now we clear our hearts and our minds to receive each other again, unless the Father returns. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Father, right now, for you are God and God alone. You are amazing, God. You rule on the throne. I feel you, Father. Oh, I thank you, Lord, that I operate in obedience in this word, Father, that it may convict somebody to turn from their ways and turn into your ways. And if their ways are wicked, that they turn from their ways to your ways, Father. Father, I thank you, God, for you are glorious and you're mighty. And I won't doubt your word, Father. Lord, keep us out of the yo-yo syndrome, God, that we're not back and forth with you because, Father, we don't want to be found on the back end. You said either be hot or cold and not lukewarm, Father, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord. I glorify your holy name for this word on tonight. Thank you for coming forth in your name. Father, right now, I want to lay Sister Tina, Sister Kawanya, and Sister Gracie at your feet. I thank you, Lord, for them. Lord, I pray against spirit of offense in the name of Jesus right now. I cancel the spirit of offense that she will no longer carry it, that she will recognize it when the enemy is coming for her, and that she will shut him down by the scriptures of pulling down strongholds and canceling it now in Jesus' name. We cancel the stronghold of offense in the name of Jesus, that she will not be the bait of Satan against her own life, but the bait of Satan against anybody else's life. Father, help her remind her of who she is, who she belongs to. And as long as she keeps saying, I am from God, and tell the devil he has no action here, He cannot breach the contract between her and the Father. So I call spirit of offense up and out of her now in the name of Jesus. Come out of her, loose her, release her in the name of Jesus. If you've been a strong man, I call you strong man of offense out in Jesus' name. Defense, you must go also, because when you are offended, defense immediately comes. I cancel that in Jesus' name, because she is not offense. She is not offended. God carried your sin to the cross in the name of Jesus, and he became the sin. He became offense. And so, Father, we thank you right now. Father, we call a healing to Kawanya now. And she got a tooth pulled, and we know how uncomfortable it is to go to the dentist, because I just came back yesterday. And so, Lord, I ask you to go into her mouth, Father, heal her properly, Father, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, for her speaking out about everything that God had in her belly. And so I give God glory for her in the name of Jesus. God wants me to come back to you, Tina, that the fact that you spoke that out, the devil is upset. He's really upset. And so, Father, I call protection over her right now in the name of Jesus. I call protection over her, the wings of God over her. I send angelic hosts to her home to protect her while she's sleeping, to protect her when she's awake, to protect her in the name of Jesus from all odd text messages, strange fire, anyone that she accomplishes that the enemy tried to send out to destroy her, we cancel that and we send fire to them right now in the name of Jesus as she releases the spirit of offense tonight. Father, I pray for Sister Gracie and her voice, Father. Heal her voice, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. That you release it, God, go into her throat, Father. Lord, send your heat, healing heat into her throat in the name of Jesus. Sister Gracie, as you was talking tonight, I heard evangelists come out. And so I heard evangelists in the name of Jesus. When you were speaking, though it was a little raspy, I heard the evangelist. God is operating in you as an evangelist. In the name of Jesus, that he's going to help you be trained in his glory to spread the word. Glory to God. He's getting ready to rise up in you like never before, woman of God. I believe that you're still feeding off of that Sunday. If you can make it to the all white place, the all white service, the secret place, come on in, get you another taste of the glory of God, we will definitely be happy to have you. And I thank God for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we just absolutely love you, Father. We thank you for your glory. We honor you. We honor you for your healing, these three women of God and anyone else who needs healing on tonight. Let your blood flow in them. And those who are watching, God, any replay viewers, Father, just touch them right now, God, where it hurts. Heal them, God. Lord, let them know that you're in control, that they don't have to worry about their family, because as long as they follow your footsteps, Father, as long as they protect themselves in your glory, Father, that they don't have to worry about it. As long as they don't lean on their own understanding, but acknowledge you, God, everything is all right. I pray for their ears and I pray for their walk, God. And anyone that needs deliverance tonight, I speak deliverance over you in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. God, thank you for every subscriber to our YouTube channel and every like in Prayer Life Ministries International. And Father, I thank you for I'm in this image, Father, Christian therapy and mentorship, Father, that you'll continue to grow it in your glory, that we'll continue to operate as you operate, Father. So, Lord, we glorify your name. And from this biblical prophetic moment, and pray for the man of God, my husband, Apostle Dr. Dexter Hall, Father, that you continue to cover him in the word and give him new nuggets, new revelation. Day by day, Father, as you give them to me. And so we thank you, Lord, for you are great and mighty as we get ready to launch into the deep. We glorify your holy and righteous name, Father. Hallelujah and amen. How are you feeling, Miss Gracie? Your voice.
Oh, I'm feeling better. It's better just some reason it's been going in and out. I talk okay, then all of a sudden it just started going in and out.
Okay, Father, go under her throat right now. Drip your oil into her throat. You have the purest oil than even our olive oil. So, Father, go in right now and drip your oil. Drip your blood into her vocal cords. Release whatever it is that's trying to hinder her voice right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. Glory to your name, Lord. What do you feel?
You want me to get the oil to use it now? I mean, I have some.
Put it on your hand and put it on your throat and then let me know when you do. Just you don't have to pour it down your throat. Melissa's virgin oil, and you trust that oil that you're there's no bacteria.
Okay, let me get it. Okay.
Okay. Amen. I'm glad to know there's heat in your guns. We're going to take care of that too, Minister Kiwanin. All right. Put the oil in your hand to touch your throat. Lord, send a fire to her hands right now. Send fire, healing fire to her hands right now. Touch her throat. And Father, it is the access of her belief, the measure of her faith in which she is already healed. I feel it in mine. So Lord, heal her now. Lord, send your blood down her throat now, Father. In the name of Jesus, loose her throat. Let your blood flow right now. Fire to her hands now. Fire to her hands now. Release the hoarseness. Release the vocal breakup. Any infections that may have tried to start, we cancel those now. Any rubbing together vocal cords illegally, we cancel it now in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
How you feel?
I feel better.
Hey!
I feel better.
Glory to God. I
sound better.
Huh?
I sound better.
You do. I felt it kind of in my throat too. To God be the glory.
Yes, I received that prayer as well.
Amen.
I've been praying and asking God to elevate me in his word, continue to take me higher, and whatever he's preparing for me, as I'm keep praying, asking me to receive it with open arms.
All right. See, operating already in the prophetic confirmation.
My plan is to be there on November the 3rd. I'm making preparation to be there on November the 3rd, me and Taisha and my son.
Yay.
So we already got our white.
Amen. Woohoo!
Done ordered me ordered me a throw off of Amazon that for me and my son that got the 91 Psalm I read on it. And we want you to pray over it. And I made my own prayer pillow.
Hey. Glory.
So I am prepared.
Amen. Amen. That's
pray that we get there. Safe traveling, Cole. That is our plan to be there.
Amen. You sound so good right now.
Thank you.
Amen. We can't wait.
I get discouraged because when I be reading the word and a lot of it I don't understand, I get aggravated. And it's like I never been good at comprehending and understanding stuff. So it's hard for me to comprehend and understand what I'm reading and everything, but I'm not going to stop.
Good.
I'm not going to stop because that's what the devil want me to do, to stop. Yeah. And I'm not going to stop. I'm going to keep on keeping on. If I just get understanding, just piece by piece is better than not getting any at all.
Exactly.
So
praise the Lord.
I thank the Lord. I just thank God.
Well, woman of God, if you ever run into situations like that, my phone is open. Reach out. I can help you bring clarity to any word that you may be struggling with the help of the Holy Spirit.
All right. I appreciate that. I get your number from my daughter, Jacqueline.
Not a problem.
Amen. Also, woman of God, if you can, before you open the word, you just say, Holy Spirit, come, I invite you in, show me the way, teach me the word in Jesus' name. And then you get started and you write down and he'll start breaking it down for you. And don't worry about being no theologist, or how do you say it? Because I'm not either.
Yes, man. But I always pray before I even get into the word. I always pray and ask God, ask me to anoint my ears. I anoint my ears, my mouth, my ears, eyes, and everything. And I ask him to block out all distraction and open my understanding.
Yeah.
Give me the comprehension of the word and guide me. And I ask him to sit beside me. And I also ask him to decrease me as he increase.
Amen. That's good. Well, hopefully that was a little added note. I figured you prayed before, so that's good. Amen. Well, praise the Lord for your healing. May God continue to heal you through the night. As his hand is your pillow and his arms are your blanket.
Thank you.
Amen. Thank you. I want to pray. The woman of God said she felt heat in her gums as I was praying. Also, I saw it earlier, Kiwanya, but I hadn't gotten a chance to get there yet. But I'm going to pray for the wild man torment to release Justin now in the name of Jesus. We call peace that surpasses all understanding to settle his mind, that his spirit man will jump up in God, the spirit man of God will jump up and handle the devil now. We cancel the access of the enemy upon his life in the name of Jesus. I saw, I think it was Justin that came with you at the conference, and the way that he was in clapping and praising the Lord and moving around, I know that God is in his heart. And so we cancel everything that's not like God, that's causing torment into his mind. I right now speak the blood of Jesus in his brain function, in every part of his brain, from his frontal lobe to his back lobe, in the name of Jesus. Lord, from the crown of his head to the soles of his feet, let your blood flow right now to every cell. Lord, line his cells up with heaven in earth as it is in heaven. We thank you, Lord. So, Lord, we are not going to stop believing that Justin is now no longer, and his mind is no longer captivated by torment in the name of Jesus. We cancel it right now, Lord. We glorify your name, Lord, because he has a worship in his heart, God. And Spirit of the Lord, of the living God, fall fresh on him right now. We send a fire to his body right now in the name of Jesus. And we believe and touch in agreement now that it is already done. So, Lord, we glorify you tonight that Justin is going to be a minister of God. He's going to speak on his own behalf of what God did for him. We speak it in the atmosphere as though it already is. So, Father, we thank you, God, that you are God of suddenly. And so, God, we right now, we minister to him right now, because there's no distance in the spirit in which you cannot heal, in which you cannot move, which you cannot breathe, Father. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that Justin would say, in him I move and in him I have my being. And so now, you tormenting devil, we call you to release him now, glory to God, through intercession on his behalf in the name of Jesus. We cancel the deaf and dumb spirits right now, and the marine spirits right now, and the strong man right now off of his life in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we cause his ears to unclog so he can hear you clearly, Lord. We thank you, oh God, for the blood of Jesus that heals, and it will never lose its power. And so we call the blood all in his vein. chains right now in the name of Jesus. Yeshua, we absolutely adore you. Jehovah Nisi, God of his victory. And his mother is a believer, and we believe with her. We are touching in agreement tonight that her son is already healed. He's already been made whole. He's going to know he is from God all the way, all the way, all the way in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord. We glorify your name tonight. Devil, you have been served notice to take your hand off of God's son. We thank you, Lord, tonight that it is already done. We're going to hear and see the testimony, even off of Gracie's son as well. Lord, we're going to hear a testimony on Sister Gracie's son. Father, pour your blood, glory to God, and send your angels to minister to him in his ear. In the mighty name of Jesus, I had already seen him standing, glory to God, beginning to speak and walk into the front altar, giving God glory for his healing in the name of Jesus. Everybody that Jesus touched was healed. Everyone that needed healing by his power was healed. So we declare healing right now in the name of Jesus. People were risen from the dead, glory to God, from asleep, glory to God. So we know a healing can come forth. Lord, we glorify you tonight for every healing, every fire, and we send that fire right now to burn out everything, the lame spirit, God, the dumb, non-talking spirit, the spirit of brain seizures or aneurysm. We come against those now in the name of Jesus. Every clot, we break it right now in the name of Jesus, that every bone shall conform its way back into the earth from heaven in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah and amen. It is so. It is so. So I'm excited. I'm excited. I'm looking forward to all of your testimonies. We already have one where the woman of God was talking with her voice was healed. We got the one where woman of God felt the healing in her, where her gums were sore. She felt the fire of God. Now we're going to see these sons healed, and these sons are going to begin to speak the word of the Lord. God bless you all. We absolutely love you from myself, Dr. Prophetess Hope Hall, and Dr. Apostle Dexter Hall, with the love of Christ. Until Sunday at 10:30 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9:30 a.m. Central Standard Time, God bless you and never look away from his presence. Just stay right there. And remember, self. Don't let self get you in trouble. Don't let the voice of another get you in trouble. Let it only be the voice of God. Stay in heavy worship, because it's evil out there, even the more. And he is coming soon. God bless you. Have a blessed night. Love you all.